Hi guys, welcome back to Madabout Designs. In this tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to design this oobling disk mechanism using Autodesk Fusion 360. This assembly is consisting of four components, and they are rotary axis, wheel 1, wheel 2, and the base. Here are the dimensions of the components and the tools and commands we are going to use in this tutorial. If you are new to this channel, do subscribe to us and turn on the bell notification so that you won't miss any of our new videos. And if you guys have any suggestions and recommendations, please let me know in the comment section. Now without wasting time, let's get into it. First, create a new design by going to Files, select New Design. The unit we're gonna use in this tutorial is centimeter. Create a new component and give it a name, base. Keep it active and click OK. Create a new sketch on the top plane. Go to 2-point rectangle and change it to center point. Select the center as the origin and give it a dimension of 13 by 40 centimeter square. Select these two construction lines and delete them. Double click on this side to select the whole rectangle, and under constraint, click on lock so the dimension of the rectangle will be locked. Go to 2-point rectangle again and draw a rectangle on this side of dimension 2 by 3 cm square. Repeat the same on this side and give it a dimension of 1.5 by 2 cm square. Now go to sketch dimension, select this side and the center and give a vertical distance between them as 1.5 cm. Select this side and the center and give a horizontal distance of 1 cm. Uncheck this show dimension option to view our sketch clearly. Go to the straight line command and turn on the construction feature. Draw horizontal and vertical lines respectively from this origin. Now under create, go to mirror, double click on this side to select the whole rectangle as the object, and for the mirror line, select this horizontal line, click OK. Right click and repeat mirror, repeat the same for this rectangle, and for the mirror line, select this vertical line. Finish sketch. Go to extrude, select the whole profile, drag it downward up to a distance of minus 1 cm. Click OK. Turn on the visibility of previous sketch by going here. Go to extrude, select these four profiles, drag them upward up to 8 cm. Operation join, click OK. Now turn off the visibility of sketch 1. Select this face and create a new sketch on it. Go to center dial circle. Select the center as the midpoint of this edge and give it a dia of 3 cm. Draw another concentric circle of diameter 0.5 cm. Finish sketch. Rotate our figure. Now go to extrude. Select these profiles. Drag them in opposite direction up to a distance of minus 1.5 cm. Select the operation as join and click OK. Turn on the visibility of previous sketch by going here. Go to extrude again. This time select these two profiles. Drag it inward up to a distance of minus 0.5 cm. And make sure the operation is selected as cut. Click OK. Turn off the visibility of previous sketch. Now, select this face and create a new sketch on it. Go to center dia circle and select the midpoint as the center and give a dia of 4.5 cm. Draw another concentric circle of diameter 2.5 cm. Finish sketch. Go to extrude. Select these profiles. drag them inward up to a distance of minus 2 cm. Operation Join. Click OK. Turn on the visibility of previous sketch by going here. Go to Extrude again. Select this profile and drag them inward up to any distance. And Operation S Cut. Click OK. Turn off the visibility of previous sketch. Now we have to mirror these two features. So under Create, go to Mirror, Pattern Type, Features. And for the objects, select these two extrudes. Mirror Plane as this one. Compute option Adjust and click OK. Right click and repeat mirror. Pattern Type Feature. This time select these two extrudes. Mirror Plane, this one, and click OK. Here all the features has been mirrored. Now go to Fillet, Fillet Type, Rule Fillet. For the faces, select this one. Give it a radius of 0.5 cm and click OK. Here is our base ready. Now go to our main assembly and create a new component. Give it a name, Wheel 1. Keep it active and click OK. Create a new sketch on this right plane. Under Create, go to Project. Select this circular profile, selection filter, specified entities. Turn off projection link and click OK. Now go to Center Diacircle and draw a circle from this center of diameter 10.5 cm. Draw another concentric circle of diameter 12 cm. Select this circle and delete it. Finish sketch. Go to Extrude, select this circular profile, change the direction to symmetric and give it a distance of 0.5 cm. So the total height of the extruded body will be 1 cm. Click OK. Now create a new sketch on this back plane. Under Create, go to Project again. Selection filter specified entities and select this circular profile. So it will be projected here. Click OK. Finish sketch. Go to Extrude. The profile has been already selected. Change the start plane to offset plane. Give it an offset distance of 5.5 cm and an extrude distance of 1.5 cm. So the body will be extruded from here up to here. Operation Join. Click OK. Now under Create, go to Mirror, Pattern Type, Feature. Select the previous extrude as the object and for the mirror plane, select this plane. Click OK. Now under Construct, create a tangent plane on this cylindrical surface. Click OK. Select this plane and create a new sketch on it. Press P to go to Project, Selection Filter Bodies and select this wheel and click OK. Now turn off our bodies. Go to Sketch Dimension, select the center and this edge and give a distance between them of 0.5 cm. Again, select the center and this point and give a vertical distance of 6 cm. Finish sketch. Turn on the visibility of bodies. Now go to Extrude command. Select this profile. Change the direction to two sides. In this side, give it a distance of 0.5 cm. And in this side, up to 11 cm. Operation Cut. Click OK. Here we have created two holes on our wheel. Now go to our main assembly. Create another component and give it a name wheel 2. Keep it active and click OK. Create a new sketch on the left plane. Press P to project. Selection filter specified entities and select this inner circle of our wheel 1. Click OK. Go to center dia circle and draw a circle from the same center of dia 9 cm. Draw another 3 concentric circles of diameter 10 cm, 4.5 cm and 3.5 cm respectively. Uncheck this show dimension option to view our sketch properly. Now hide our wheel 1 and base 1. Go to 2-point rectangle and change it to center point. Select the center of the rectangle as the center of the circles. Give it a height of 0.5 cm and a length between these two circles. Repeat the same, but this time draw a vertical rectangle. Select all these construction lines and delete them. Go to trim and trim out these unnecessary portions. I'm going to fast forward this part. Finish sketch. Go to extrude. Select this profile. Change the direction to symmetric and give it a distance of 0.5 cm. Press enter. Turn on the visibility of base 1 and wheel 1. Now under construct, go to mid plane. Select these two faces so a mid plane will be created in between them. Click OK. Click on this home button and create a new sketch on this mid plane. Hide base 1. Click on the top plane. Press P to project. Select these two edges. Turn on the projection link and click OK. Go to center dia circle and draw a circle aligned with the mid of these two edges of diameter 0.5 cm. Go to sketch dimension, select the center and this edge and give a horizontal distance of 0.5 cm. Hide wheel 1. Finish sketch. Here is our profile. Go to extrude. The profile has been already selected. Change the start plane to offset plane and give a offset distance of 4.5 cm and give extrude distance of 1.25 cm. Change the operation to join. Show wheel 1. Here is our extruded body. Click OK. Now we need to mirror this feature. So turn off the visibility of previous construction plane. Under create, go to mirror. Pattern type feature, and for the object select the previous extrude. For the mirror plane select this one and click OK. Hide the construction plane. Here is our wheel 2 ready. Go back to our main assembly and show base 1. Create the last component and give it a name rotary handle. Keep it active and click OK. Before sketching anything, go back to our main assembly, click on move, move objects, components, select the base from this point and the wheel 2. Deselect the base so that we can rotate our wheel 2 with respect to this handle. Rotate it at an angle of 30 degrees. Capture position and click OK. Now activate our rotary handle. Click on the back plane and create a new sketch on this plane. Press P to project. Selection filter specified entities. Select these two circles. Select these faces. Turn off the projection link and click OK. Now go to straight line command and hide our base and wheel 1. Start drawing the figure as follows with proper dimension. Pay attention to all the dimensions and the angles. If you face any kind of problem while designing this sketch, feel free to ask me. Now go to 3-point arc, select the first point here and the second point here, and make it tangent with this line and keep drawing the figures as follows. Here I have provided the Make sure you provide the dimensions properly. In this sketch, I have also drawn 3-point rectangles. Now go to straight line command, select the first point as this center and the second point on the midpoint of this edge. Double click on this arc to select the whole profile and delete it. Delete this circle too. Here is our profile ready, so finish sketch. Go to revolve command, select these profiles and for the axis select this line. Click OK. Turn on the visibility of previous sketch by going here, right click and repeat revolve. This time select these profiles and for the axis select this line. Type full and click OK. Right click and repeat revolve. Select this profile and for the axis select this line. Click OK. Now go to extrude. Select these profiles. And give them an extrude distance of 1.25 cm. Direction symmetric. Operation join. Click OK. Hide the previous sketch. Press F to go to fillet. Change the fillet type to only fillet. Click on these edges. And give them a radius of 1.25 cm. Press enter. Again press F to go to fillet. Select this circular edge and give it a radius of 0.5 cm. Press enter. Now under modify, go to chamfer. Select this circular edge and give it a chamfer distance of 0.25 cm. Here is one side of our handle ready. Hide wheel 2. Now we need to mirror this part, so under create, go to mirror, pattern type, bodies, and for the object, select this part, and for the mirror plane, select this circular face, click OK. Hide our first body. go to move command, click on the circular face of this body so that we can rotate with respect to this face. Move object bodies and rotate this at an angle of 180 degree. Here is our handle ready. Now combine them, select these two bodies, operation join and click OK. Turn on the visibilities of wheel 2, wheel 1 and the base. Go back to our main assembly. Here you can see all of the components are not joined together. We need to join them. Revert to the original position. Before assigning any joints between them, we need to ground our base. So right click and make it ground so that it won't move from its original position. Here you can see. Now under assembly, click on as build joint. For the first component, select the handle, and for the second one, select the base. Motion type revolute, and for the position, select this circular face. Here it is rotating properly, so click OK. Press Shift J to directly go to as build joint. This time we will select the wheel 2 and the handle. For the position, we will select the cylindrical face of our handle. It is rotating properly, so click OK. The sequence I am following here, make sure you do the same sequence, otherwise it may not work. Now go to joint. For component 1, select this inner circular face of our wheel 1, and for the component 2, select this circular face of our wheel 2. Our wheel 1 is rotating properly, so click OK. Now again go to as build joint. For component 1, select the wheel 1, and for component 2, select the base. For the position, select this circular face of our base. It is rotating properly, so click OK. Now if we rotate our handle, here you can see our wobbling joint is working properly. Go to joints, right click on revolve 1 and animate model. Hide the joints. Here you can see it is working properly. Now press A to go to appearance to assign some colors to our components. I'm going to use this metallic black and yellow and white color on them. Here is our wobbling disc mechanism ready. Right click on revolve 1 and animate model. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you like this video, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. See you in the next tutorial. Till then, keep designing and design whatever you love. Bye bye.